I'm going to Thank you. Thank you. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yes, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, your rod and your staff, they comfortest me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou hast anointed my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. In my father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. But I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, you know, and the way you know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Father, your word declares that whatever we do in life, we should do all in the name of Jesus Christ and for your glory. We thank you for calling our dear brother into glory by your side now, because we know he received Jesus Christ as his Lord and personal Savior in this life. For this we thank you. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ over this funeral celebration, Lord, and we ask you to take absolute control. You are welcome. We give you all the glory for the celebration of such a dear life. To you alone be all the glory, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living.
You may be seated. Our first reading is going to be led by Priscilla and Martha. John chapter 14, verses 1 to 6. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto me, the Father, but by me.
Amen.
stand as we sing the second hymn, Abide With Me.
Faced with the reality of death. For our loved one, Brother Francis Oppong, has now come to the end of life. So even now, we put our trust in you. Give us comfort in our soul. Help us always to focus on you, on the reality of eternity that you offer when we follow you. In Jesus' mighty name,
amen. Please remain standing as we sing the next hymn, which is When Peace Like a River.
Thank you. ye sorrow not, even as others which have not known him. For if we believe that Jesus died again and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Them which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words.
Amen. We're now going to read tribute by the children, Christabel and Elvis Pong, and also the grandchildren.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Jermaine Ayate, and I'm going to be reading a tribute to my late grandfather and on behalf of my sister, Brianna Ayate. This tribute is about my late grandfather, Francis Oppong. My grandpa was a great man, highly intelligent and a hard-working man. My grandpa took care of my grandma in her difficult and desperate times. My grandpa was very protective, kind, and supportive to his family. He was the best at telling funny jokes and making us laugh. When we stayed on weekends, Grandpa would make my sister and dad cocoa with some bread and eggs. It was really delicious. My sister and I deeply miss all the fun we shared with our grandpa, not forgetting the presents and gifts on Christmas and birthdays. We are also going to miss sitting on his lap, his hugs and kisses. We love you so much, Grandpa, and we will forever miss you. I hope you'll look down on us and be proud of us. Grandpa, the Marifa, do you? Come on.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Christabel Oppong, and today we are gathered here to say goodbye to my father, Francis Oppong. It is difficult at best to stand before you all and attempt to honour my father in words. It is never an easy task to capture someone's life in a speech. My dad loved nothing more than being surrounded by the people he loved and who loved him back just as much. I remember as a little girl, I would stand by the window, knowing exactly what time my dad came home from work. As soon as I saw a glimpse of his car, I would run and shout to my mum, "The lion is coming, the lion is coming." Then I would sit down and act like a good little princess. Daddy roared like a lion, but was as soft as a teddy bear. My dad was such a character. Daddy had the best sense of humor that rubbed off on anyone that was near him. I will always remember that special smile, that caring heart, that warm embrace you always gave me. You being there for me through good and bad times, no matter what. I'll always remember you, Daddy, because there will never be another one to replace you in my heart. And I will always have love for you. Love you, Daddy. Rest in peace and look down on us.
Hello, everybody. Thank you all for being here. My name is Elvis Oppong, and I was Mr. Oppong's only son. To me, that was such a blessing, and he cherished me highly. My dad was the definition of a real man. He had a heart of gold and made sure everybody around him was okay. He treated me like a prince and always made me laugh. I remember every Sunday he will make me breakfast. And my mum will always say that you've spoiled your son. We didn't bond over a lot of things, but we had a deep love for football and that brought us close together. We supported the same team, which was the best feeling ever. I will never forget all the debates and arguments we had and times where he wouldn't speak to me for 3 days. He showed me how to be a real father and provide and to be a protector. He showed me how to respect everybody no matter their journey in life. He also showed me how important it is to work hard and achieve your target. The impact he left on people's life is a true inspiration, and that is what I aspire to be as I grow older. He never stopped telling me the importance of leaving a good legacy for the next generation, and now I've had a full understanding of what that means. The one promise I have today is that I will make you proud, and your spirit will be full of happiness. I love you, Dad, with all my heart, and I know you'll follow me everywhere I go. I know you're right next to God, and he's welcomed you wholeheartedly, because he was the best dad in the whole world, and he was a great husband. I was so lucky and fortunate to have you in my life. Although I'm saying goodbye, I know one day we will meet again in paradise. You're at peace now, and I will never stop missing you, and I'll never stop loving you. Rest in perfect peace, Dad, aka the Lion.
Amen. Before we say the closing prayer, I think I will just say something short on behalf of my family and my late uncle. Where should I start from? 20 years ago, life was just like a roller coaster for me. But he showed me a way through God. Uncle Oppong, as I always called him. And so rather unfortunate that 2 days to his death, he called my mother and he said, "Sister, fetch me wife, that the whole of the union and me move because of the pandemic. I'll come home and see you after, you know, everything." The next phone call we receive is Uncle. I thank God for the life that he lived. Some people went through pain before they died, but in his case, I don't think he suffered. He's an old soldier. They said old soldier never die. So in my heart, he will never die. He helped me so much. I lost my dad, and those days my mother had a stroke. That was millennium. Being a single parent, and I had my daughter, Ellie, who is in Birmingham today, watching us live through Dwumfour. And they took caring, looked after him. He said to me before I left to the airport, which I missed my flight because of a long talk from him, you know, "You're the only child for your mother, but to us, you are many. So we are with you in the spirit, with the wife." They looked after my daughter, looked after my mother in the hospital for me. And because of that, I had the energy to go and bury her mother for her and my dad at the same time. In this country, we know if someone takes you in their house for one day, be grateful. By him, all you have to do is knock the door or pick up the phone and call him. He will be there. He will leave everything and attend to you and have time to speak to you. I don't have anything bad or anything. I can't say. The only thing that can come out of my heart and from my mouth is praise for him and his wife. Mommy, he's gone, but he's not gone. He's with us. Because what he has seen put in our heart is bigger than what anyone can say. People can say my condolence and leave you. But if we reflect back, let's reflect back on whatever he did with us. The laugh that he gave us, the memories that he left us. And let's stand on it and give thanks to God for what he has done in our life. Even though he's not here in the flesh, We know where he is in the spirit and in us. So on that note, we will thank God for his life and the life that he gave us in the time that we had with our father, our uncle, our brother, our everything. We give glory to God. And on this note, I will ask Pastor Michael to come and pray for us and the family as well.
Thank you so much. I just want to say one or two things in addition to what you've said in the first reading. But I will not have you to be ignorant, brothers and sisters, concerning them which are asleep. Do not sorrow, even as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them which sleep in Jesus. That is the whole purpose of life. God, as you said, God has a plan for everyone. In the book of Hebrews, he said, it is appointed unto everyone once to die, not twice, once after death, there is judgment. You see, that appointment date, when you breathe your first breath at the midday hospital, then he puts it on your hands. It's only God who knows. It's got a precise time, precise minute, and a precise second. When that time happens, even if you are the pilot carrying about 456 people, you have to leave and present yourself to God. Now the point is, after that, say after death, there is judgment. And that is what you and me should always make sure that we are walking on this world or in this world, taking into consideration the fact that we have an assignment, we have something to say to our Maker. Jesus, someone came to him and said, what can I do to inherit eternal life? In Matthew chapter 22, Jesus looked at him and said, Lord, your God with all your heart, and love your fellow human being as yourself. He said, upon this, all the laws and the sayings of the prophets were summarized. And so, even as you see, I once had the opportunity of being pastoring him, and like you were saying, yours, one of our prayer warriors, you play the instruments as well, and we learned a lot from each other. That is why when I went to see Sister Agi, I said, did you ever hear Brother Oppong Blackie ever stand somewhere to say, no, I renounce my declaration of Jesus Christ as my Savior. I renounce. No, I'm no more a Christian. Whatever be the storms in life, no, I refuse to take Jesus as my Lord. He said, no, he never heard. I said, good. Now the Bible says, if we believe in our hearts, the Lord Jesus, that he died in us, and confess him with our mouth, we shall be saved. The rest belong to God. But once someone confesses with the heart, man believeth unto salvation, righteousness, and unto, with the tongue, salvation, a confession is made unto salvation. So we can biblically, with all confidence, 100%, that our dear brother is resting in the bosom of our Lord Jesus Christ. And for this, we thank God. Amen. The rest, we have to also make sure we love God with all our heart. Let us prioritize God in our lives. Let us love our neighbor as ourselves. So that when the second reading, at the voice of the trumpet come, they will rise first, and those of us who are alive will also be caught together. This is called the next agenda on God's timetable. It's coming to pass. When you look at book count, look at the busyness of life, it's so easy to forget this. Mount Calvary, it was exactly as the way that said. So everything God has said,